more than fair. That's how Philippine National Security Advisor Hermógenes Esperon Jr. describes Manila's oil and gas deal with Beijing in the West Philippine Sea. The area is part of Manila's exclusive economic zone in the South China Sea, which Beijing claims in its entirety. Esperon, the chairperson of the National Task Force on the West Philippine Sea, says the 60-40 sharing agreement in favor of the Philippines gives Manila an advantage over Beijing, since China would be spending for the proposed joint oil exploration.
They're spending for it and we're getting more from the net. More than fair, right? We simply talk about it as
sovereign rights. Economic.
As a sharing that is just a fair for us and for the other side.
Top maritime affairs analyst Jay Batumbakal shares a similar view.
The 60-40 sharing formula is precisely the formula prescribed by the Constitution, and it's also the same formula that the Department of Energy has been applying to all of its contracts. It would be good if that position is the minimum position that the government takes in dealing with China on this, and if China accepts that minimum position.
But Tumbakal says it's best that Manila have control over the exploration activities in the West Philippine Sea.
If we somehow relinquish any form of control over this this development and exploration activities, then that would be that could be a sign that we are giving up some measure of our sovereignty or sovereign rights. So that's where we have to be very careful.
Esperon says a joint steering committee with representatives from both Manila and Beijing was formed last week. It is scheduled to meet next week to discuss the joint oil exploration. He adds officials from the two countries are eyeing to explore the western area of Palawan, where Reed Bank, locally known as Recto Bank, is located. In November 2018, Manila and Beijing signed a Memorandum of Understanding for oil and gas exploration during Chinese President Xi Jinping's state visit to the Philippines. Esperon also says the Philippine government is set to lift the moratorium on maritime scientific research by foreign governments. He adds research is the first step towards sustainable development of marine resources, which will benefit Filipinos in the long run. But he says foreign researchers must seek permission first from the Philippine government.
We will build the National Academic Research Fleet, and we will lift shortly the moratorium on marine scientific research by foreign government and institutions.
But Tumbakal calls for the involvement of Filipino marine scientists in research activities in the country's waters.
Even if there are foreign scientists, what's important again is if it is a Filipino-managed, Filipino-directed research, and that all the results go to Filipinos. Now at least Filipino marine scientists can go there and they can take on board some Filipino scientists.
Esperon's pronouncements come as the Philippines and China sign more bilateral agreements following Chinese Vice Premier Hu Chunhua's visit in Manila.